This is game four. The New York Rangers have a series lead of 2-1, and we are underway. Bobby Carpenter out on the faceoff against Mark Messier. Jeff Bookaboom back to get it. Near side for Messier. So the line stays together for the Rangers as they've got Messier out there with the Graves. And Anderson, Glenn Anderson bringing it up ice. Anderson with Graves following. Graves pass intercepted by Scott Stevens. Stevens has been on the ice for the last 9 goals scored by the Rangers against the Devils. He has had a bad series against the Rangers, a -5 for the leading plus minus man in the league.
One of the reasons he is a -5 is that he has not generated any offense. He led this team in total points during the regular season. He doesn't have a point in this series, and I really think that because he is out there against the Messier line very often, he is thinking D before he thinks offense.
Which is the way Jean Tremere wants it done, has all year. John McClain moving in. McClain's got Jim Dowd and Stefan Richer. His shot is blocked. Driver the shot. Save made. Rebound. Level out in front of him. Taken away by Brian Noonan out of the zone. Kenny Danico back. Danico, Edessa took it on him. Here comes Nemchinov on side. No. Living offside, but the Devils clear. Jim Dowd. Bernie Nichols not playing. The center position of the New Jersey Devils has been the one area on this team where if they have a weakness in depth, that is it. Corey Millen being asked to fill that role tonight. He is out there right now with Billy Guerin and Valeri Zalapukin. Tipped in but offside by Corey Millen. Elmore Gandy.
One of the more notable elements of that Nichols suspension with the swiftness with which it was delivered. There is some precedent for being suspended during a playoff series. Remember Adam Graves gone? Well, there was a couple of days between that when Brian Burke took over as VP, kind of the dean of discipline. He said things are going to happen quick, and they sure did.
All right, Al. Bernie Nichols out of there. There is no appeal process anymore in the National Hockey League. Suspensions are immediate. Brodeur the save on Jay Wells, and that deflects into the seat.
So here comes Carpenter now to face Mark Messier. This line in game three played about 85% of the time against Mark Messier, but Bobby Carpenter is hurting. He took 5 minutes of the warm-up in this before this game, headed off for the last 15 minutes of the warm-up. I didn't know if he was hurt. Maybe he's just pacing himself, but he is not 100%. It is his right knee.
And he does have a brace on there. Fired up by Tom Chorsky. Lemieux is open. Lemieux, the shot, missed it wide side. Held on to by Stevens, deflected and covered up by Richter as Bobby Carpenter tipped it in on Mike Richter. Bobby Carpenter in the playoffs, a lot of ice time, and there'll be even more tonight. He's had a goal and 6 assists playing at a +1 in the playoffs this season. Lowe goes back to get it. Gilbert on the near side. Greg Gilbert kicked it away. In 6 of the 7 starts this year that Brodeur has had against the Rangers, both the playoffs and the regular season, the Rangers have scored in 6 of those 7 games in the first 6 shots on goal. The Devils know that. Ken Danica's wide open, missed the net. And the Devils are doing something to cross up the defensive coverage of the Rangers.
I think the Rangers are just a little sloppy, Gary. I mean, there's nothing fancy by the Devils, but they are, in fact, open.
Kevin Lowe centered right through the crease, had Gilbert cutting. By side, Zuboff held it in. Picked up by Driver. Gilbert ended up in the net with Brodeur. Millen, who can fly. Guerin, save made. Mike Richter, Devils getting a couple of chances early. Zuboff has it in the corner. A huge game. The Devils can send this back to Madison Square Garden even. The Rangers, if they win, can go back up 2. Bobby Holik put that hit on Zuboff, who skated away. Peluso puts the shot on the other side.
I think it's realistic to say that this is the New Jersey Devils season if they do not win this.
Wraparound chance. Bookaboom couldn't get it. Zuboff trying to center it to the near side. Chased down as a Tikkanen put the hit on, but the puck came free at center. Jay Wells. Wells just dumped it along the boards. Couldn't hit Nemchinov. Niedermeyer will touch it up for the icing call.
Well, there's no score here, and it may be a long night for the Rangers if they try to establish their hitting game because the Devils appear to be ready to screen him out. There is Joey Koser. Here's the puck going this way, but watch Bruce Driver take Koser on the play and not let him by. See how he screens him out? He rides him right into the corner. That's what the Devils did not do well in game 3, and the Rangers established their hitting game as a result.
Chorsky got it out in front. Shot. Carpenter again was all alone. Lemieux back for Chorsky. Chorsky, Lemieux, and Carpenter in this new line for the Devils. And on their first 2 shifts, they've created some opportunities. Mark Messier, leading scorer against the Devils, tried to draw it in. Tommy Avila knocked it away. Messier has a goal and 4 assists in the games against New Jersey. Lemieux whacked at. Lemieux takes Leach down. That's twice Leach has been dunked unceremoniously in this first period by two different doubles.
It was the other way around in game three, wasn't it? In one shift, he cold-cocked Claude Lemieux twice and sent him flying.
Bobby Abelin brings it up. Abelin through center, take it off the play. John McClain reached back. Three on two, three on three. Jimmy Dowd. Dowd dropped it back to the point. Nobody there. Devils were changing, so they've got two D back. Kovalev brings it in. Alexei Kovalev with Bruce Driver on him. Kovalev and Driver. Packed house. Driver took him down. Over 19,000 here. Centering pass low. Couldn't get it. Steve Larmer turns. Tried to shoot. Deflected away by Ken Daneker. They had 19,040 the other night. They'll have even more than that tonight above a capacity crowd at SRO. Look at Mike Richter. Moved out with Richie there. McLean trying to put a hit on. Danico sends it back in. Kovalev knocked it away, and the Rangers come back up ice. Stefan Matteau with a double overtime game winner. What a delight to see a professional athlete celebrate the way he did. Unceremoniously jumping up and down on his skates like a 9-year-old kid.
Agreed. It is so much fun to see a guy that happy. I said to him tonight before the game, I said, I was worried that you were going to clear the glass. He said, you know what? I was too. He said, I got way up into the air.
Shot in by Wells underneath Brodeur's stick. Craig McTavish sends it back. In the corner, Wells centering pass for Gilbert. Wells holds it in. In front, Gilbert. Turn around. Koser blocked. That one hit the defenseman. Fetisov in front. Peluso clears it out. Richter's going to come out to play this. Puck was on in. Jay Wells, who had a lot of playing time considering what he'd had in previous games in that last game, is playing a lot here in the first period. Greg Gilbert jammed it in by Niedermeyer. Fetisov there. Slava Fetisov got turned, sends it to Bobby Holley.
I think Mike Keenan is conscious of how long and how hard his players played in game three with that double overtime, and he has rolled his lines over consistently so far in the first period, and his defense pairing. Everybody has played for the Rangers.
Valeri Zalpukin takes the hit, held the puck in, lost now to center ice, Hesatigana. Tigana, the man with a kiss on his lips at all times, sends it into the corner. Fetisov back to get him. Slava clears it up the boards, and Holley could not hold it in. Tigana got dumped. Tikkanen had nobody around him as the Devils were changing it up. That's why Marinelli probably let that go and did not make a call on it. This will be an icing call, touched up by Stevens. The number one and two teams during the regular season, the Rangers and Devils, and they have gone at it just as a one and two team matchup should be. Kevin Lowe, Messier won the faceoff. Last game, the Rangers won 59 draws, the Devils 37. Scott Stevens along the boards, had it tipped away. Bobby Carpenter's got it. On the series, the Rangers lead in draws 140 to 107. Had the advantage in the faceoffs. Messier up. Stevens got turned. Messier in. Messier the shot. Brodeur the save. As he beat Stevens, he got him turned sideways and went by him. And that's what's been happening to Scott Stevens. Mike Richter comes out to get it and clears it around. Stevens brings it in. Drops it off for Graves. Lost it. Lemieux. Claude Lemieux. That one shot wide right into Kevin Lowe. Lowe will start it up. Rangers changing. Len Anderson was going to the bench very slowly. Lemieux in. Shot deflected wide. Boy, Anderson was going nowhere on that change, and it almost cost his team a goal. He was just kind of waltzing over to the bench and didn't realize the puck had been passed to him. Lemieux stepped in and took it away and went in alone. Dumped into the corner. Carpenter's over there. Cut off Larmer. Cleared back out to center. Bukovin. Bukovin and Brian Leach. The pairing defensively. Brodeur, the rookie, holding it up behind the net. Stefan Matteau. Matteau almost dug it out. Danico finally controlled. Leach at the point. Dropped it into the middle. Centered by Kovalev. Tipped by the defenseman Stevens. John McClain starts it out. Knocked down by Kovalev. Kovalev over Richer's stick. Danico again tipped it away. McClain sends it up ice. No score. 12 minutes to go in the first. Shots are 4-3 in favor of the Devils. Driver tangled up along the boards. And the puck is rolling in behind the net. Kovalev trying to kick it away. Couldn't get it away. John McClain controlled it, centered around the board.
Boy, the Devils aren't letting the Rangers get any forechecking speed up at all. As soon as the puck is dumped in, the Devils' defensemen aren't even concentrating on going back and getting the puck. They find the nearest Ranger, put a hook on him, and slow him down. And then they go into the corner at least together instead of with the Ranger guy bearing down on his back.
John McClain sent it up and then heads to the bench. Both teams completing line changes here. Devils still have not cleared the zone. So it'll be brought up easily out of the zone. Waiting, Karpatsev is someone who's gone in ahead. McTavish, he gets back on side. Near side, Niedermeyer couldn't stop it. Wells trying to send it in, and that's deflected over the glass and into the seats. 11-13. Left to go here in the first period. We've called a from the rock line out there for the Devils. Three of the hardest bodies in the National Hockey League, McKay, Peluso, and Bobby Holik. There won't be a lot of points. There will be a lot of penalty minutes, and there will be a lot of hits.
But they want to produce. Mike Peluso told me before the game he's still second-guessing himself. He had a couple of good scoring chances in Game 3, but they didn't happen for him. I tried to console him by telling him that he was shooting on Mike Richter. I mean, he's been a pretty good goaltender. But they are a real momentum line for Jacques Lemaire. He puts them out very often after the opposition has scored to try to get some of the momentum back, generally by hitting the opposition or by getting a quick goal. You can get the momentum back. Well, they're not going to go out and score very often. But boy, oh boy, they stop you in your tracks with their hitting game.
Held on to is Corey Millen as he tried to get into the zone. Zalapukin tipped away by Esa Tekkinen to Noonan. Zuboff in his own zone. Zuboff and Kevin Lowe are teamed up defensively. Intercepted at center by Noonan. Noonan has played extremely well in the playoffs for the Rangers. 4 goals, 6 assists, 10 points, and a good checker. Niedermeyer trying to clear. Noonan's there. Noonan taken out of the play. Nemchinov stepped up, couldn't get it. Zuboff moves up on Zalapukin, and Dow's come away with a puck. Another one of those pinches Bill's been talking about that controlled the puck at least momentarily. Guerin got it out the center. Millen drops it off. Zalapukin, a whistle and an offside. Corey Millen had already entered the zone.
Mike Keenan, Jacques Lemaire, I mean, that means that they're in control. I mean, if you're a coach that ends up saying things impulsively, you usually live to regret them. But these guys say things, and even if you think they're impulsive because they happen so quickly, believe me, they are measured. They know what they are doing.
Bukovom gets knocked down by Chorsky. Rangers have taken the worst of the physical play here in the first period. Chorsky the move. Leach blocked the puck. Graves and Carpenter. Chorsky! Partial save, I think, deflected out in front. And Richter may have gotten a piece penalty coming up. Lemieux shot deflected. And the Rangers are going to be shorthanded as Graves touches it up. The first power play of this game will go to the New Jersey Devils. The hooking call on the Rangers. 9:59 to go. First period, no score. He is the third leading scorer in the playoffs and number one among defensemen in scoring. And these are the first 2 minutes worth of penalties he's picked up in the playoffs this year.
Is that amazing? And it's not because he does not make contact.
No. He does it well under the rules.
Here's where the Devils have to get it going. They're 1-for-12 in this series, but they only have 12 power play shots in 12 power plays. You can't win when you only get one shot per power play. You got to get 2-3 anyway.
And the Rangers have the number one penalty killing team during the playoffs. In front, shot, score!
This is one of the new lines that Jacques Lemaire has together for this game. Jim Dowd is at center with Richer on one side and McLean on the other. That baby just popped right out to Richer, and he quickly stepped out front and just rifled it. See, Kevin Lowe went for the pass. Never came. Went right to Richer. Five-hole shot as he stepped out front.
Only the fifth goal given up by the Rangers when they've been shorthanded. 5 out of 55 chances, but a huge goal for the Devils, and they take the 1-0 lead. Ticket and fanned on the pass. Randy McKay. Mike Peluso sends it around the net. Jay Wells is there. A 1-0 lead for the Devils. They get it on their sixth shot of the game. That'll be whistled on the delayed offside call.
Their first lead in the series. This is game 4. They had won a game, but they went into sudden death overtime. So as soon as they scored, time expired, and they didn't get any credit for a lead in that game, which was game 1. Let's see how they react to the lead. You know, they are more aggressive already in this game. So far, the Rangers have pinched in at the offensive blue line with their defensemen, which is a containment move, and it's an aggressive move. The Rangers have done it 7 times, the Devils 6 times. That is very unusual. It's usually about a 10-to-1 ratio, Rangers to Devils. Not tonight so far.
Adam Graves, his shot deflected into the seats.
And did you see who Jacques Lemaire came right back with after that goal? He came with his rock line with Peluso and McKay and Bobby Holik. But right now, back with this line. I mean, Mike Keenan and Jacques Lemaire do that a lot. If a line gets out there, has a good shift, does something productive, in this case, this line scored a goal, get him back out there as quickly as you can. You don't want to let him sit there when that until the adrenaline wears off.
Take advantage of anything that gives you a little spring. Face off one here by rookie Jim Dowd. Cleared up ice for Richie. Way offside. And there's the whistle. Richie and Richie did a little dance and separate themselves. 8:58 left here, first period. New Jersey Devils leading it by a score of 1-0. Joining us here, of course, as always, Elmore Gandy.
I had a chance to talk to Scott Stevens before the game, and although he tried to shrug it off, you could tell he was very upset about the fact that he'd been on the ice for the last 9 consecutive goals by the Rangers. Of course, during the regular season, plus 53, so that's a pretty hard start to explain how this could happen in the playoffs and being a free agent looking at $3 to $4 million range. He said he expected there'd be 2 Rangers coming at him at all time, but he has to learn to stop going at them so aggressively, let him come in and step around. Guys?
All right, El Brodeur down, but the puck went behind the net. All the way up the center ice, John McLean. 3-on-2 break. Ticket and trying to get back to even it up, and he does. McLean got turned by Lowe. Stefan Richie. Richie, a little room, takes it. Save made by Richter. Right straight up in the air to Larmer. Larmer backs it up for Zuboff. Zuboff behind his own net, forced there by Stefan Richie. McLean gloved it down. He cannot hold it in. It's loose at center. McLean came back to get it. Zuboff will play it in the zone. The Devils outdoing the Rangers here in the first half of this first period. Offside Anderson as he moved in.
Earlier in Scott Stevens' career, he was absolutely a hothead. Mike Keenan knows that. Scott Stevens used to turn around and come at anybody that touched him. You could goad him into a fight very easily. But for the last 6 seasons, his penalty minutes have declined every year. And this year, the lowest penalty minute total of his career, he scored more points than any other season. But the Rangers in this series were really able to do some business, and I think throw Scott Stevens off his game.
It has worked up until this game. Tommy Avalon overskated, came back to get it. Stevens finished 5th in defensive scoring with 78 points. And along with Bork and McGinnis is one of the final 3 for the Norris Trophy that will be announced at the end of the Stanley Cup playoffs. They could wrap that series up and never go back to Toronto. And Toronto is hurting right now physically. Doug Gilmore is playing with an ankle that is being frozen before the game. He has no feeling in one of his ankles. I don't know how a hockey player can play that way, but he's doing it. Mike Peluso held it in, goes to the corner, Karpatsev over, cleared around the boards, held in again by Driver. All alone, shot down, just missed. Or Randy McKay, rather, and I mean just missed as he went wide side. Wells has the puck underneath him. The Rangers being held down in shots in this game now. They've only got 3, and we're down to 7:35 to go in this first period. Rangers being outshot 7-3 and trailing 1-0. Off is Anderson with Larmer. Anderson to Larmer. Larmer trying to spin around. Tommy Avalon tied him up. Anderson puts it in front. Bobby Carpenter is there. Devils transition game, maybe the best we've seen in this series. Bukovon put the hit on Chorsky, but Chorsky got it out of there in a hurry through center.
You know those screens, those holdups that I've been talking about, we telestrated one of them. When those are effective and you get it done, the guy that goes back to get the puck has a chance to get his skates pointed up ice. When that happens, he can make a play.
Claude Lemieux, what a save made as he used Lowe for the screen.
Bobby Carpenter's knee looked okay on that hit. What a great, great shove into the pile. Sometimes you don't even have to hit a guy hard. If you recognize there's a situation you can jam him into like Carpenter did, you create a problem. That was a good play.
Right off the faceoff, Jim Dowd got a shot in there. Fetisov going back. No whistle on this. Dowd plays the puck. Dowd starts it up ice. The rookie has Richie and McLean with him on the line. Richter going back to get it. Mark Messier. Messier pinned up in the corner, lost it. Messier reached out, got away with a hook probably. Richie looking for it in front, puck checked away by Graves to center. Bobby Carpenter's out there to watch Messier in this top line. There he is with the puck. Here's Karpatsev with it. Rangers fighting to get onside. They do. Good draw. Karpatsev, the defenseman, moving in, tried a backhand shot. Niedermeyer picked his stick up. Niedermeyer couldn't pin it up. Graves looking to the middle. Fetisov's on him, Adam Graves. Graves just dropped it back a little deeper. Coming to the middle. Not a lot of room. Lemieux intercepts in the centering pass by Nemchinov.
I don't think Mike Keenan is happy with what he is seeing. He is juggling his lines already. When he does that, it's usually a sign that he thinks his team is flat and he wants hitters out there. Kocur was out there with Messier and Graves on the last shift.
Chorsky dropped it off along the boards, had it blocked by Wells, bounces out the center. The Devils have come up and they have the extra step here in this first period. And they have the 1-0 lead on the power play goal by Stefan Risché. On the dasher, on the back of the net, Ken Danico. Wide side for Valeri Zalapukin. Zalapukin has got 3 goals and 2 assists in this year's playoffs. Cleared right back out of the zone by Kocur. Back in by Driver. Zuboff goes back to get it. Zuboff near side for Gilbert. Gilbert sends it out. 5:19 left in the first. Shots are 9-3 in favor of the Devils. Devils trying to even this series up at 2-2 with a win here and there home ice. Nemchinov in a 2-on-2 the other way with Anderson. Puck checked away by Driver. Zalapukin came away with the puck. The Rangers have lost only 2 games in this year's Stanley Cup playoffs. They are 10-2. The New Jersey Devils coming into this, having a 1-9 and lost 7. Cleared around the boards. Driver will try and get it out of the zone, and the dive just left it for Bobby Holik. Belusso sends it in. Mike Richter, Wells, and Bobby Holik. Holik's got the puck. Wells tied him up, and a fight. Mike Peluso and Jeff Bookable.
And did Peluso ever tag him early in that fight? I think he surprised Bookaboom by coming with the left, and it looked to me like he landed the first one straight on the chin.
And there were just the 5 for fighting, no instigators. So Bookaboom and Peluso at 15:22 pick up the first majors of this series. And they just go and sit with only 4:38 left to go. They've gone to the dressing room. They'll be out for the rest of this first period on the 5-minute majors. Teams remain 5-on-5. Picked up by Fetisov. Slava Fetisov cross ice for Risché has got the goal. McLean came back to get it. Shot it right into Jay Wells. Loose at center. Fetisov again bangs it ahead. McLean's there.
Gary, I haven't seen Mark Messier for a couple of shifts. This is that line that we just talked about as having been put together with Graves at center, Metto on the left side, and Kocur on the right. Now here comes Larmer on the right side, but Mike Keenan's juggling like crazy.
All over the place. Jim Dowd brings it in. Dowd looking to the middle for Risché. Open shot. Save made. Great play, Dowd. Fetisov fanning on it. Dowd waited and really set it up. Graves, he's got a man open. Metto couldn't get it to him. Graves in, shot, deflected into the seats off Niedermeyer's stick. The Rangers have not had a shot on goal for a long time. Shots are 10-3 in favor of the Devils. The last 2 games, it has been just the other way around. Lowe got it up on Corey Millen, the glove in his face. Puck still along the boards, cleared up by Billy Guerin. Larmer wide side, Steven stepped in front of him. Larmer hangs on to him. Shot into the zone, Zuboff back to Lowe. Lowe dropped it behind the net. Zalapukin on Zuboff. Limer hit by Guerin. Outstanding forechecking, and then hit again by Zalapukin, who leveled Limer on the far side. And now Guerin on the near side hits Gilbert. Back up comes Limer. Limer hauled down, and Zalapukin will get away with that one. Stevens to Billy Guerin. Guerin's onside. Billy Guerin scores!
Richter owed Billy Guerin one. He owed him one from game 2. This huge hit by Zalapukin happened down in the Rangers' end. Then the play went to the other end before Guerin came back. He had great speed. Mike Richter came out to meet him and didn't back up fast enough, and Guerin made him pay. Terrific goal. He was robbed when the score was 1-0 in the third period of game 2. He made no mistake on that one.
And we're going to get a new Ranger goaltender. Mike Richter, who came into this game in this series with a 1.49 goals against, had given up only 6 goals. Glenn Healy is going to come on in his stead. Healy's over there trying to stretch. He doesn't get time to warm up, so Dan Marinelli wants him out there and ready to go. And he's taking his time. I don't know if the Rangers have used their time out here or not. No, he hasn't. Marinelli's going over to get him. There's supposed to be no warm-up here. He could get a delay of game and Mike Richter being pulled.
We're going to show you what happened to Steve Larmer in the play. Watch him go in deep here and get pulled down. That was the problem for the Rangers. That's how they got caught up ice. All right, if we stop it right here, you can see that there are three Rangers behind that line, and away they came.
And Stefan Richer along the boards, got it up to Bobby Holík. Holík moves through. Leach is there and took it away. Leach for Nemchinov. It's behind him. So Glenn Healy is in net. Healy has played in only one game in this postseason. Coming on in relief of Richter. Now he's in with no warm-up. Stripped of the puck. Kovalev took it away. Nemchinov, Anderson, and Kovalev. Brought in by Nemchinov. Devil screaming. That was offside. Nemchinov along the boards. A whistle by the referee, Dan Marowelli, as the net has come loose. Played only 25 minutes in the playoffs. Coming on for Richter, shot wide by Zubov.
But don't be surprised if Mike Richter gets back into this game, depending on what the Rangers do over the next little while.
Yeah, this is more of Mike Keenan saying to his other players, you're not getting it done for Mike Richter. Chorsky got dumped in a penalty coming up on the Rangers. The Devils are dominating this first period. They are out shooting the Rangers 11-3. They have a 2-0 lead with 2:09 to go.
Why Kevin Lowe is off for tripping. Tom Chorsky danced by him on this play. He doesn't take Chorsky down. Chorsky with his speed is right in on Mike Richter.
The New York Rangers have given up just 4 power play goals in the playoffs, but one of them came in this game. They are 1-for-1 tonight. The Devils are. Tommy Abelin, his shot tipped, knocked away by Healy. Zubov cleared it around. Messier picks it up. Rangers are shorthanded and down 2-0. Richer and Guerin have the goals for the New Jersey Devils. Lowe went out at 17:51 on this trip. New Jersey's now 2-for-13 in this series on the power play. Tommy Abelin brings it in. The defenseman down low, Jay Wells. Wells trying to clear it around the board. Zubov there to help out. Dowd poking at it. McLean gets it. McLean back for Dowd. Back to McLean. Stevens at the point. John McLean is shot. Knocked away by Glenn Healy. Near side, Stefan Richer. Power play's got a minute 13 on it. McLean held it in, lost it to Messier. Messier will just clear it out. The Jersey Devils getting a turnaround in game 4 here at home. With this 2-0 lead in the first, not having led in the series against the Rangers until that goal that gave them a 1-0 lead in this game.
And they have hardly established a hitting game in the offensive zone in this series. That is, to me, the most noticeable difference for the Devils. You draw your emotion from the hits that come in the offensive zone. You expect them to come in the defensive zone. That's part of playing deep. But when you can hit in the offensive zone, you get some emotion into the game, and that's what the Devils have done.
Corey Millen, Devils still on a power play. Leach intercepts and clears. 32 seconds left on the power play, 39 seconds left in this first period. John Saunders will be along during our first intermission. Take a look at that Toronto series with Vancouver. Take a look also at New York Rangers leading goal scorer Adam Graves. Driver holds that one in behind the net. Guerin tied up, 10 seconds left on the power play. A little more than that in the period. Corey Millen brings it out. Back to the point, Driver, Millen. On that far side boards, there he is with the puck. Penalty is over. Driver the shot wide. Glenn Healy never saw it. Picked up by Guerin. 2 seconds to go in the period. Guerin dumps it towards the middle, and this first period's over, and it's won by the Devils in every way.
Rangers have totally out-hit the Devils, but the key is that more than half of the Devils' hits, they had 15 of them, more than half, 8 of them, came in the offensive zone. That is the difference for the Devils in this game, too.
Devils have picked up the lone power play of this game, and that had not been working for them either. They were able to get one in that first period on the first goal. We are underway here in the second. Koser shot it right through the crease of Martin Brodeur. Rebound, Messier tried to center it. cleared up along the boards by Carpenter. Not out of the zone, however. Zubac held it in. Joey Koser. It's Koser now with Graves and Messier. So Koser's out there a little protector role right now on this line, maybe for Messier. Graves doesn't need any protecting. Messier doesn't either, but I'll put some more weight out there. Shot in by Stevens, partially blocked, knocked down by Carpenter. Played by Zubac in his own end to Kevin Lowe. Just underway, second period. Rangers lead the series 2-1. They'll be back at Madison Square Garden on Monday night. Stevens blocked it as he came in front of Brodeur. Cleared up by Danico. Near side, Tom Chorsky to Lemieux. Lemieux down and Chorsky head to the bench. Glenn Healy came up to make the save. Down! Cutting in, got a shot. What he tipped it in on Healy.
Surprise. I mean, Karpatsev put it right into Dow's skates.
And good play made by Healy, who just held his ground. Danico on the far side. Checked up. McLean cleared it away to center. 2-on-2 the other way. Brought in by Dowd. Dowd crisscrossing Richie. Sends it into the corner. John McLean over to get it. Put it up through the middle of Driver. Driver the shot. Blocked by Larmer. McLean. Dowd behind the net. Ryan Leach moved in on it. Leach has pretty much been kept out of this game. Has not handled the puck much. Has not had scoring chances. Has put a couple of hits on, but got knocked down about three times in that first period by the Devils. Dowd working behind the net. Leach is on him. Dowd's pass intercepted and cleared up by Karpatsev.
Yeah, both Brian Leach and Mark Messier sat for portions of the first period.
And that'll be an offside two-line pass to John McLean. Kept going at that pace. You don't do that. And again, Carter Mike. Wells cleared it out of the zone. Zubac going back to get it. New York Rangers. Incredible that they have had only three shots on goal. 2-on-2, 3-on-3. Mateau shot, block, rebound. Picked up by Bobby Holik. Fetisov blocked that shot. Holik brings it in to Randy McKay. McKay wide. Healy may have gotten a piece of that off the end of the glove. Squeezed up along the boards. Now to center to Mateau. Mateau, his shot blocked again. Niedermeyer. Mateau behind the net. Picked up by Fetisov. Slava turning it for the Devils. Bobby Holik in the middle. Hooked by Kovalev. Played by Zubac. Rangers try to mount some kind of offense. Leach in. Leach dropped it. Messier trying to move it back. Taken away. He tried to draw it back and Zalapukin tipped it. Billy Garen has got a goal. 2-on-1 with Holik. Save made by Healy. He's got it in the glove. A 2-on-1 breakout for the Devils, who have a 2-0 lead. Elmore Gatti.
Glenn Healy playing this game without a neck protector. We don't know why right now. I'm going to try to find out and give you the message.
Yeah, he doesn't have that on. I'm sure that's not a comforting thought. Cleared out the center. Tommy Abelin back to get it. Abelin swung it back into the middle. It'll be chased down by Bukaboom. Bukaboom behind his own net. Rangers still looking for their first shot in this period. 3.5 minutes into it. Near side, two-line pass. Joey Koser whistled by Swede Knox. There you see the unprotected neck, throat, and everything else of Glenn Healy. Those goaltenders have a lot, as much as they can get, wrapped up around there in order to protect themselves from shots that come in that area. What a job he's being called on to do.
That's wide open. That is absolutely wide open and vulnerable, the neck area. There's the little dewlap that Martin Brodeur wears hanging down, which most goalies have. Some goalies don't even have that, that have the long mask. You see Brodeur's mask comes down and covers a good part of it. Some goalies don't have anything that hangs on that, but Brodeur does it the safe way and has even more protection. But Glenn Healy on the shot we had of him, wide open.
And he's got that gold chain, so that'll block off a lot of shots. Shot right through the crease by Larmer. Lucky Mark Schott isn't here. He wouldn't be playing. Larmer dumps it in the corner to Nemchinov. Blocked again. Corey Millen's got it. Millen clears it out.
But then again, hockey players don't wear earrings.
And not on the ice anyway. It's against the rules. Cleared away to center. Poke check. Zubac's got it. How about the team that was playing Cincinnati the other night? I think it was the Dodgers. They all wore earrings. Garrett has it knocked in. Driver back for Danico. Cleared it up. And where is it? Ended up going over there on the Ranger bench somewhere for the whistle.
Bukaboom actually said it was in the Daily News in New York. He said, yeah, it's the time of year where there's blood on the ice and you play with bruises. He said, this isn't baseball, you know.
He hasn't been around baseball lately.
Yeah, right.
Stefan Richie. Kick to the near side. Fetisov. Joey Koser holds it in on him as they do battle on the boards. Centering pass in front. Backhand shot. Brodeur the save on Mateau. And right now, Stefan Matteau is probably the outstanding Ranger on the ice. Patisov has been tied up with Joey Koser in the corner. Marinelli has called at least one penalty here. Here are the New York Rangers on the power play. Leach sending it in. Brodeur reaches out and hangs on. The Rangers finally getting a couple of shots. They didn't have a shot for over 16 minutes in this game.
But we're finally getting a chance to see a little bit of Martin Brodeur. What a quiet first period he had. And now that Fetisov is in the box for roughing, we will probably see a little bit more of Brodeur. He slept till noon yesterday. He told me that he had a great sleep and feels great. That overtime game, the double overtime two nights ago, didn't bother him at all. He felt great. Slept till noon.
Held in momentarily, then underneath Leach's stick. Chased down by Zuboff at the other end. New York Ranger power play has been the second best in the playoffs. 15 for 65 during the playoffs, and that's offside. The Rangers just right now can't push the right buttons. It's not working for them.
Marc Messier played six shifts in the first period at even strength, and Bobby Carpenter was out there for every one against him. What is interesting is the faceoffs. 11-1 by the Devils and 11-1 by the Rangers. That's not the interesting part. Seven different Rangers took faceoffs because they were playing center in the first period. Their regular guys, Messier, Nemchinov, and McTavish and Kovalev, but also Gilbert took one, Larmer took one, Tikkanen took one, Graves took one.
Everybody's getting a chance because nobody's playing very well. Devils clear it out. Lemieux shorthanded for the Devils. That is Esa Tikkanen. Lemieux and Tikkanen do battle on the boards. Zuboff will get it. Rangers have a minute 11 left on this power play chance. New York Rangers in this series have gone 3 for 13 on the power play against the Devils. Cleared around. Larmer, poke checked away from him. Messier dropped it back for Larmer. Larmer from behind the net. In front shot, Graves. Great save, Brodeur. Through a screen on a quick one-timer by Adam Graves.
He had him. I thought it was by Brodeur. But then again, I thought that about 30 times in this series. Graves ended up taking the pass from Larmer. And watch Brodeur's right leg. I think he got it with the right pad. Yep, it looked like he was extending with the right pad to make the save. Quick on his own rebound, too.
You see the Rangers starting to get a few shots here because of the power play, but still being outshot 15 to 6 in the game. On the boards, Bobby Carpenter clears down to 40 seconds to go in the period in the power play. Zuboff back to get it. Zuboff from behind his own net. The Devils have the 2-0 lead. Rangers, power play chance, Kovalev in and offside.
The Devils are obviously prepared to play, not willing to pack in their season. Hey, if they win this one, this series can be theirs. There's no question about it. It comes down to a three-game series. Anybody can win the best of three.
Yep. Shorsky won the faceoff all the way to the other end of the ice. 20 seconds on the Ranger power play. Shot way wide, Nemchinov the rebound, picked up by Kovalev. Kovalev, Stevens down on the ice, and it bounces up over the glass into the seats. 10 seconds remaining on the power play for the Rangers.
Alexei Kovalev didn't want to talk very much about the potential suspension. He didn't say anything after the suspension was handed down to Bernie Nichols today, but even yesterday he said, you know what, I don't care about a suspension. I don't care about anything except playing and winning the Stanley Cup. And he was more upset at Bernie Nichols for what he thought was an intentional shooting of the puck into his face than he was the cross check. He uses a funny looking stick too. I mean, it almost looks like a boomerang. You can see how it's rockered on the bottom. And that allows him to take a shot from just about any position because it's not flat on the bottom of his stick. Did I pick that up well enough?
You did very well because that wasn't what was supposed to come up there.
Okay.
Nemchinov has it along the boards. Near side, Karpatsev, power play over, deflected. Fetisov, who just came out of the box, has it. Is Aaron Bass intercepted at center by Wells. Wells drops it off. Moves back to the middle. Nemchinov dropped it off. Chorsky is there. Rangers trying to get their line straight here. So are the Devils. A 2-0 lead for the New Jersey Devils. Icing call on the Rangers. 13:26 to go. Second period. Devils leading it here by a score of 2-0. Faceoff coming to the right of Martin Brodeur. Kevin Lowe's shot was wide. Even strength, Rangers did not convert on their power play chance. Set in by Anderson. It's Anderson back out there now with Graves and Messier. The line has been together most of the season. Near side for Bobby Carpenter. Carpenter's shot was blocked by Zubats, and that'll end up back in the seats.
The Devils have sure used perhaps the Bernie Nichols suspension as kind of a rallying cry for themselves, because they have just charged like crazy in this game. They've really played well. Best game so far in the series for them. Even better, I think, than game one.
Dominating first half of this game. Karpatsev clears it out. Dumped in by Esa-Tekinen. Intercepted Niedermeyer. Back for Richer. Richer and Guerin have the goals for the Devils, both coming in the first period. One on a power play. That was Richer's. Intercepted. Nemchinov shot blocked. Off the blocker. Mistake for the Devils. They get away with it. Esa-Tekinen. Tekinen trying to dump it in front. Patisov was there, and it's cleared up by McLean. Karpatsev chasing it down. Just get it through Richer. Nemchinov to check at center, but Patisov is there and sends it in. Glenn Healy is in for Mike Richter. Healy playing in just his second game of the playoffs, as he, of course, was the backup goaltender all season long for the New York Rangers. Richter having the great year that he did. Near side, Esa-Tekinen. Tekinen takes a dive, and there was no call. Sent back in by Jay Wells. Held onto by Brodeur behind the net. During the regular season, Healy ended up going 10-12-2, appeared in 29 games for the Rangers. Whistled on the offside call with exactly 12 minutes left to go in the second period. Elmore Gandy.
He had Adam Graves' skate being sharpened, but while it's being sharpened, Graves on the bench with only one skate. Another pair of skates being brought out to him on the bench. Get him back on the ice as quickly as possible. They all travel with the extra pair of skates, but they like that one first pair. They're a premier player. He's going to get him as quick as he can.
Well, that was Mike Folga, who was sharpening the skates, and he has a couple of players, especially Stéphane Matteau, on this team that wear very old skates. He said everybody else with the players come to the bench, they're still watching the game. He said, I'm looking down to see what kind of shape their skates are in, because I'm afraid that they're actually going to fall apart. Matteau's are so flimsy, he wants to make sure he has a pretty good grip out there, and he gets his skates sharpened 3 to 4 times every game, regardless of the edge that he has, just as a security blanket, 4 times a game.
Keep that machine running. Stevens takes it in behind the net. Center ice, Zalapukin. Zuboff was on him. Picked back up by Limer. Steve Limer, 5 goals, 6 assists in the playoffs, and a whistle coming up and a penalty. A tripping call on Stevens and Zalapukin looking at one another. It's one of them.
Well, is it?
I think so, Valeri Zalapukin.
Yep.
Well, the Rangers get another power play chance here, down 2-0. They did not convert on the first opportunity. There's Valeri Zalapukin.
But this can hurt the Devils. If they give the Rangers power plays, this can hurt them, flat or not. You're always running the risk of losing your lead, especially against the Rangers power play.
Rangers, who had the number one power play during the regular season with 96 power play goals, go at it again here. The Rangers are now 3-for-14. In the series against the Devils. Messier dropped it off. Tommy Avalon got it up. Held in by Esa-Tekinen.
Boy, Tikkanen's playing the point. Brian Leetch isn't even out there on this starting power play unit.
Zuboff back to Larmer. Larmer, Messier. Messier centered. Shot, score! Stefan Matteau! The door just creaked open a bit.
Yes, sir. What a terrific pass by Marc Messier. Matteau just had to kind of redirect it. And this is where the Rangers have gotten open on their power play. Graves had a chance from here, and Matteau scores now from the same spot. Terrific pass. He had to get it elevated. Watch this. Oh, man, he had to elevate it over a stick and then land it right on Matteau's blade. Just a redirection for Stéphane Matteau, but a big one. The Rangers are in this. Maybe this will get them going.
He scored the double overtime goal to end the last game, and he gets the next Ranger goal to put him on the board in this one. They get it on their 8th shot, and it is a 2-1 Devils lead as the Rangers 1-for-2 on the power play tonight. They get a one-goal game. Bobby Hollick cleared it out. Kevin Lowe comes back to get it. Greg Gilbert dumped it to center. Hollick took the shot from Koser. He freed the puck up. Nemchinov in. Nemchinov shot. Save. Rodeur rebound. Loose behind the net. Gilbert. Rodeur gets back up and in place. Zubov, he guns it in. Tipped wide. Nemchinov. Niedermeyer over. Koser steps up. Joey Koser's getting some ice time here tonight. Held onto by Gilbert. Gilbert taken away by Bobby Hollick. Swung back to center, and Fetisov brings it up. Fetisov sends it in to the Ranger end. Peluso, a big hit on Kevin Lowe. Picked up by Gilbert again. Gilbert wide side to Kovalev, and a whistle. That's a two-line offside pass.
Boy, the Rangers went for the jugular right after their goal. Nemchinov will win the draw to Kevin Lowe. This is a set play. Watch him split the D, and if the puck doesn't go over his stick, he ends up with a breakaway, but it did jump over his stick. But the Rangers had a set play on there. They wanted to tie it right away.
Jay Wells up the board. Adam Graves trying to clear it out. Ken Danico held it in. John McClain swept it into the crease. Karpatsev right in his skates. And Glenn Healy covers up the puck.
And Bobby Carpenter is not out there. This trend seems to be changing. Jacques Lemaire has not tried real hard in this period so far.
Rese! Glenn Healy the save! He stole the puck from Kevin Lowe!
And that's why when you're a goalie in your own end of the rink, you've got to be prepared for a shot even when the puck is on your guy's stick.
Karpatsev got leveled by John McClain behind the net. Rangers down by one, send it into the zone off Danico. Limer and Danico along the far side. Dowd over to play it, got it back for Driver. Bruce Driver. Driver and Ken Danico, the two Devils, have played in every Devils playoff game in their franchise history. Centered for Limer, but it came through to Karpatsev.
Another interesting line combination by Mike Keenan. He has not finished juggling Messier with Larmer and Matteau.
Matteau is playing probably the best of the Ranger forwards right now. A very good night for him, not only because he's got the goal, but he's just been right place, right time, getting it done.
Yep.
Catch him in a line change. Joey Koser's got Gilbert open. Gilbert was all by himself as the Devils got caught in a line change with a pass went over his stick. There's Gilbert who's seeing some ice time. Gilbert's got Koser and Nemchinov with him. Nemchinov the puck, taken away in a back check by Bobby Hollick. Hollick, he gets in trouble, taken down. They push it by Nemchinov. We have not seen Brian Leetch in this game for a while. Cleared ahead by Peluso. It's getting hard to keep track of who's in and who's out. Randy McKay drops it off. Bill mentioned Bobby Carpenter hasn't been out there on those faceoffs. Brian Leetch hasn't been out at all. Bobby Hollick puts the hit on the far side. Banged up in the air by Avila. Shot right back in by Anderson, or at least attempted. It ends up in the seats. Guys like Brian Leetch are very proud players who don't like sitting.
No, and he's a sensitive player as well, and he was a dominant player in Game 3 here two nights ago.
Well, that's a bit of the psychology of coaching going on right there. Zubov. Zubov dropped it to center. Chorsky had it, lost it. Anderson tried to clear it in, got hit, but he got it in. Kovalev centered again! Whoa, what a chance in front for Adam Graves. He got hauled down by Fetisov. He had Fetisov doing battle in front. Centered again, hit Fetisov. Graves, turnaround shot, blocked out deep. Nice play by Graves to poke that away.
Well, the Rangers have stepped up to physical play, and they have started to drive the net. When they get across the blue line, if somebody has time that's carrying the puck, the other guys are just trying to drive in on Brodeur, and that's how you get back into a game emotionally.
Claude Lemieux starts it up behind the play. Fetisov still going at it, and a penalty coming up. Lemieux got dumped by Kevin Lowe, and Lowe will go for Trippett. And the Devils will get a power play leading here 2-1. Fetisov all those seasons with the Soviet Red Army team, recognized as one of the game's great defensemen in its history in the world. Now playing for the Devils and being spotted by Lemaire during the regular season, but playing a lot in the playoffs. Here's a power play for the Devils, their third of the game. They have scored on one. They are 2-for-14 in the series against the Rangers. Dowd, Zalapukin. Dowd goes to the middle, intended for Zalapukin on the far side, blocked and cleared by Jay Wells.
A good play in front. I think it might have been Karpatsev that blocked it. He was tying his man up, and he was still able to get his leg in front of the pass.
Short-handed, Karpatsev shot blocked by Billy Guerin.
This series, Mark Messier has a goal and four assists. That is more points than all of the Devils centers combined. Jim Dowd picked up an assist on the first goal that the Devils scored in this game. So all of the centers that have played for the Devils in this series so far have four total assists. Messier is ahead of all of them, and he has had to face the checking line every game.
And again, pointing out the Devils' weakness, if you wish to call it that, a lack of depth may be a better term, and that's at that center ice position. Back it comes to Stevens. Power play, 57 seconds left on it for the Devils. Swept up, not out. Stevens holds it in. Centering pass for Richey. Block Boogaboom gives it the big whack. They do battle in the corner. Richey and Boogaboom. Puck freed up to McLean. Back to the point. Driver. Stevens. Partially blocked. McLean shot in front. Coming up. Lemieux tried to backhand it in and didn't get much of it. And Glenn Healy covered the rolling puck.
Oh, man, Claude Lemieux will be playing this one over in his mind depending on what happens in this game. He had Healy where he wanted him. He just couldn't get the handle on it. John McClain got his shot to the defense, and then it bounced to the side. Lemieux just fanned on it. There's Brian Leetch. Leetch may have had a part in Lemieux's fanning. He looked like he was trying to make contact with Lemieux's stick, but when you have him down and you got the puck in front of you, your eyes get big.
Devils leading it 2-1. Rangers lead the series by that same number, 2-1. And again, Messier won the draw. And it's cleared out of the zone by Karpantsev. Karpantsev in the last two games getting more and more playing time for the New York Rangers. Having not played a lot in the playoffs overall, 24-year-old, good size, 205-pounder, 6'1". Confidence. That's the mistake he makes right there. Billy Guerin shot blocked, rebound shot wide. Wells deflected it to the corner. Jim Dowd lost that one. Cleared up and out of the zone. Messier coming. Messier shorthanded. Messier with Graves. Thought someone was trailing, but they were making a change behind him. Niedermeyer leaves it with Driver. Power play is over. The Devils 1-for-3 in the power play tonight. Do not convert. Rangers have killed it off, and we're back to full and even strength. Billy Guerin. Guerin off for Corey Millen. Millen in place of Bernie Nichols. Suspended because of his cross-check in the last game, not playing tonight. Richey has got a goal. Spun around us at Ticketon. Richey drops it off. Ticketon will remember that. Into the corner, Richey. Richey back to the point. Shot Stevens. Save made by Glenn Healy. Millen over. Corey Millen back for Richey. Guerin, the other forward on this line. Pinned up by Jay Wells. Richey's really working out there and cleared out.
He said that Issa Tikkanen will remember that. He should have known it before he got beat. With Stefan Richey, if you play the puck in situations like that near the blue line, you will be standing there and he will be gone with the puck.
But where did he go? Cleared in by Bobby Holik. Glenn Healy out to get it. Holik on the far side, knocked it down, using his great strength, able to hold it in. Holik's backhander, low in front, off the near sideboard. Joey Koser. Koser, Nemchinov's in front of him, flips it in. Off the bottom of the board, Brodeur back to play it. Nemchinov got it. Brodeur gets back in net. Centering pass taken away again. Holik cleared to center. Pelusa. He drops it off for Randy McKay. Brian Leetch back up. Put the shot on McKay. Boogaboom cleared it up. Not out. Held into. Held onto by Holik momentarily. Mateau gets it out of the zone. Kovalev. Kovalev with Leetch. And Leetch is offside as he got in ahead of the puck. 4:15 to go in the second. Devils 2 and the Rangers 1.
Watch this. First one move. Then the big one on Tikkanen coming up. Yahoo!
Behind the net, Martin Brodeur, who has given up the one Ranger goal on 11 shots. Devils, 2 goals on 18 shots. Richter started. Came out after the score was 2-0 in that first period. Glenn Healy on in his stead and is still in there. Cleared up the low shot. Brodeur has trouble with it. It was loose. He's looking, and there's the whistle. Brodeur had trouble finding the puck. Gilbert and Niedermeyer exchange gloves to the face. So Carpenter will move in to take this faceoff against Nemchinov, who won it to Wells. Wells, his shot saved. Brodeur, penalty coming up. Delayed call. It's going to be on the Devils. In front of the net, a holding call on Kenny Danico. And Danico grabbed Joey Koser going by. I think he thought Koser was going after somebody, but Koser wasn't.
What a guy to have on your side at this time of year. Issa Tikkanen gets bigger and better as the situation grows. Nothing rattles him. He seems to love this. Anybody that can do dances and blow kisses and things of that nature in the heat of battle and still play with the intensity that he does.
Brodeur makes the save. Power play underway here for the New York Rangers, who are trailing by a goal. Kenny Danico, who has played in all playoff games for the Devils, a rivalry with the Rangers.
Well, I guess you have to say so, yeah. I mean, it takes time to develop because, as you know, in the past, our team maybe wasn't as strong as the Rangers had been. But, you know, now that we were 1-2 in the league during the regular season, the crosstown rival, yeah, there's a disliking and a little animosity. So that makes for a great playoff series. Amongst the fans, this is probably more so than the players.
Yeah, it is a mild rivalry. You could safely understate that. Esa-Tekinen starting it up. Third power play of the game for the New York Rangers. Hope checked away by Tommy Abbott. Nice play.
Don't you think, Gary, that this series will, if the rivalry is not fully established as one that is a terrific rivalry, this series will take care of the rest.
Yeah. I'll tell you one thing, Bill. There is no worse outcome for the New York Rangers than to lose to the Devils in this series.
Yeah, there would have been losing to the Islanders in the first round.
Maybe.
I agree with you. No, I agree with you.
I'm not sure that it would have been any worse than this. They've gotten by that round now, and it makes it even worse to kind of get this close to that cup and have the Devils beat them. And it puts real pressure on the Rangers because their fans, I think, would all just fall down in Manhattan and never get up again if that goes on. Leet sends it ahead. Brodeur to make a save. Wouldn't count it anyway. Offside. Mateau had stepped into the zone. The Rangers on a power play. 2:25 to go in this period. They've got 41 seconds left on the advantage, trailing by one.
Well, Mike Keenan's decision to play his bangers and his grinders quite a bit more, I think, has paid off. This game has sort of stabilized. The Rangers have picked it up quite a bit. Seems to be an even playing field now. They've generated power plays by driving the net, just getting shots on Martin Brodeur and getting to the net and forcing the Devils to drag them down. So Mike Keenan, when the tempo isn't there, tries to play his grinders and his hitters to get the emotion into the game. I think it's pretty well even right now.
He's got it, yes. He's brought it back to a level playing here after the Devils dominated for the first half of this game. Ryan Leet drops it off. Ranger power play still underway. Anderson down low, center for Kovalev. Driver was there. Kovalev pushes Driver. Can't get the puck away from him, though. Near side, it comes out of the zone. Good play by Driver to clear. Karpontsev chased deep by John McLean. Lemieux knocked away by Mateau to Leet. 9 seconds on the Ranger advantage. Devils lead it 2-1 for Anderson. Nobody touched it. Brodeur let it go by. And there's the touch-up for the icing call. You see, since the cup was last won by the New York Rangers, the Canadiens, 20 cups. Indians have won a World Series. President Clinton's been born. All since the Rangers last won. The kind of stuff that drives the Rangers absolutely crazy. Closer behind the net. Stevens gives him the lift. Even strength now as the Rangers do not convert on that power play. Both teams 1-for-3 in the power play tonight. Cam Danico up for Richie. Knocked down by Zuboff. 1:22 left to go here in the second period. Jim Dowd gloved that one down at center. Off for Richie. Richie the move again. Not this time. Zuboff stripped him of the puck. Dowd held it in. Behind the net to Jay Wells. Shots are 18-14 on the game in favor of the Devils. They got their 2 goals in the first period. Jersey Devils in this series, in fact, in the playoffs as a whole, have really had a hard time picking up goals. It's been the defense that's won for them. Brought in by Richie, lost the puck. Here's a chance up ice for 2-on-2. No, can't get it in time. Messier centered. Bounces off bodies to the wide side. Guerin. Zuboff plays the loose puck, drops it off for Kevin Lowe. Devils changing it up near side. Larmer. Steve Larmer. He sends that one in off the boards. Messier chasing. Messier pushed at it, but couldn't get anything on it. Brodeur covers.
That's a good play by Steve Larmer. He just tried to cross corner dump. The puck came out, and then it was just a man-to-man battle. The Devils did well to keep Mateau from getting to it.
Vancouver does not want to go back to Toronto, obviously, and with those games at home, 2-3-2 series, they've got a chance to wrap it up if they can win the 3 straight games there at home. Not an easy task by any team in any playoff. Karpontsev knocked away by Chorsky. 24 seconds left to go in the period. That hit a Ranger in the face. Stefan Mateau has got the goal. Caught that puck in the face. Sent it drifting over to the bench. Lemieux puts the hit on. Cleared up along the near side. Mateau let it go. Cleared to center. Nemchinov. Nemchinov dropped it off. Rolls in on Brodeur. 6.1 seconds left. Both teams kind of waiting for the clock to run out, and it didn't go as fast as they thought it was going to. toe at a puck bounce up. You see him checking there. Caught him right in the jaw.
I mentioned Stéphane Matteau's skates. They are 3 years old. Now, in human years, that's about 84. They are so beat up and stitched up that Mike Folga, the equipment guy, is afraid they're going to fall apart. As a matter of fact, in game two in Madison Square Garden a few nights ago, the toe cap on one of his skates actually busted loose. And Matteau said, without a word of lie, he could have clipped his toenails right through the toe of his skate. And he played 15 minutes with his toes like that.
He is crazy. Stevens, save made by Glenn Healy, and that's going to do it. We've completed two at the Meadowlands. The Devils, two. The Rangers, one after two. Mark Messier comes out to take the faceoff. Stéphane Matteau is going to stay on this line with him, and Steve Larmer, Joey Koser have both worked on this line tonight.
Boy, Mark Messier has won 17 of 20 faceoffs.
Big night for it.
I mean, if you're above 50%, you've had a good night. 17 out of 20 is phenomenal.
Bobby Carpenter, Larmer's out on the line with Messier and Matteau right now. Carpenter won that draw back to Tommy Avalos. Through center, knocked away by Matteau to Lowe. Lowe sends it in. You joined us late. Bernie Nichols of the Devils is not playing tonight, suspended for one game with a cross check that he put on Kovalev in the last game. And interesting in the announcement by the league that they used the term vicious in describing that cross check on Kovalev and announcing the one game suspension. Brought in Messier behind the net, knocked away. Matteau could not get it. Tony Avalon there first. Zuboff and Avalon. Zuboff moves in, gets the puck. Back into the middle, Messier. Messier circling. Messier dropped it. Nice play by Bobby Carpenter, who stepped in to knock that away. Cleared up. Zubov's got it. Third period just underway. Rangers and Devils both 1-for-3 in the power play tonight. Richey and Guerin scored in the first period for the Devils. Dowd and McLean assisted on the first goal at 10-17, a power play goal. Stevens assisted on Guerin's even strength at 16-54. Stéphane Matteau got a power play goal for Messier and Larmer at 8:47 of the second. Jay Wells drops it off for Nemchinov. Martin Brodeur, the young rookie in net, will hang on. Corey Millen coming out to take a shift here. Millen's playing in his 42nd career playoff game.
And Bobby Carpenter was banged up in game three two nights ago when he tried to move to his forehand coming to the blue line on Jeff Bukaboom, only to catch knee to knee with Bukaboom and went down, left the game, came back and played later.
Joey Koser kicked it out in front. Millen was there, away to Billy Guerin. New York Rangers, who are 10-2 in the playoffs. This is only the second time in this year's playoffs that they have entered the third period trailing in a game. Nemchinov dropped it behind the net. Koser trying to wrap it in. Brodeur covering.
Here's what Koser tried. He just tried to put it into Brodeur's feet. That is not a bad play, especially if you're going to follow up for your own rebound. The Rangers have gone to an absolute blue-collar approach of just getting it into the net, getting it at Brodeur, and then driving for the rebounds.
Adam Graves. Devils are 6-1 in the playoffs when they've had a lead going into the third period. They've got one here. Lowe's pass, partially blocked by Lemieux, cleared up to Kovalev. Kovalev spun around at center ice, dumped it to the blue line. Kutisov, over to Carpenter, two-line pass. He'd thrown that from the zone across the blue line and the red line. Meadowlands packed, an offensive house right now for both these teams. We're in this third period. Take a look at our scoring summary. Stéphane Richey, seventh of the playoffs at 10-17. Down to McLean on the power play. Devils made it 2-0 also in that first period. Goal picked up by Billy Guerin on a nice breakaway at 16:54. Stevens got the assist. The New York Rangers answered in the second period. Stéphane Matteau's fifth of the playoffs on a power play. Messier and Larmer the assist at 8:47. Larmer wins the draw over to Graves. Graves shot blocked. Blocked by Niedermeyer and went wide. Kutisov. Kutisov running it up the boards. Lemieux dumped it away to center. Carpenter tipped it up in the air on low. Picked up by Anderson. Glenn Anderson tried to spin it back in. Kutisov lost control of it in the middle. Messier shot side by Brodeur. Set up on the far side to Larmer. And Larmer tried to run it in on the short side. And Martin Brodeur just held ground. Up for Lemieux. Great chance for the Rangers. Lemieux leaves it to the point. Holink shot wide. Rebound all the way up to the blue line and bumped into the stands by Stevens.
Well, he hasn't been all that busy in this game, but it looks like he's going to get busier. good play by Steve Larmer to get the puck along the boards, and he went to Anderson, back to Larmer, and Brodeur. The key there, he never lost sight of the puck once and was in perfect position when Larmer let it rip.
Tommy Abelin knocked down that pass. Billy Garen's got it. Garen sends it over to Dowd. Dowd with Zuboff on him, taken by Mateau. Mateau, right side, trying to put it into the middle. Joey Koser couldn't reach it. Dowd, right back out, low, in. Brodeur behind the net, Stevens. Stevens and Tommy Abelin. Abelin on the near side. Joey Koser just got hit. A penalty coming up, and it's going to be on the Devils. And is it going to be a two or a five? Koser's down. Marinelli's going over to see how serious it is. Hang on.
Yes, sir, hang on. He was just crossing in front, and one of Abelin or Scott Stevens was trying to run interference. And remember, we have talked about the Devils holding up the forecheck by the Rangers. They have done it sometimes legally, sometimes illegally, but then so have the Rangers. That is the nature of playoff hockey. You clutch and grab to try to buy time for your teammates. Well, this time, a stick got up on Joe Koser as he circled in front of Brodeur.
May have been Martin Brodeur, the goaltender. And Marinelli's still waiting to make the decision here on whether this is going to be a two or a five. Marinelli's looking as Joey Koser gets up.
Well, his options are two twos.
It's a two.
Yep. Or five, so best case scenario for Jacques Lemaire and the Devils. Well, see, he was already going down from the hook by Tommy Albelin.
Well, here's a huge point in this game. Billy Guerin goes for high sticking, gets only the 2 minute minor at 3:16 of the third. The Rangers get their fourth power play of the game. They are 1-4-3, 4-for-17 in the playoffs against the Devils. And the Rangers with a chance to tie it up with a power play, the best power play during the regular season, belong to the New York Rangers. Esa-Tekkinen stepped up. Carpenter banged it away to center.
Ryan Leach still not on this starting power play unit. Esa-Tekkinen is the point man in Leach's place.
Wow. Back to center, Messier. We have no reason to believe Leach is in any way injured. He just has not had a particularly good game, and he's been set. Messier turned around. Graves gets it behind the net. Larmer looking, tried to jam it in. Brodeur covers it up and will hang on.
Look at these numbers here. Martin Brodeur has appeared in 13 playoff games. He's averaging 70 minutes per start, and 60 minutes is a regulation game. That's how much overtime he has played. Now, I said he has played in 13 games. If you take the number of minutes he has played and divide by 60, he's actually played 15 games. Even though he's listed as 13, he's played the equivalent of 15 games.
Chris Carrera, the backup goaltender, has done a lot of watching. Lemieux trying to clear it out. Esa-Tekkinen blocked the first one. This one's blocked by Graves. Power play Rangers. Graves shot deflected wide. Larmer was right in front. Messier's pass intercepted by Carpenter and cleared. Ryan Leach leads the Rangers in the playoffs with four power play goals. Steve Larmer has picked up three. Good stand-up check put on Messier by Driver. Along the boards, Graves, Messier, Driver, and Lemieux are all there. Backed up, didn't go far. Lemieux clears it out. 50 seconds on this Ranger advantage. Zuboff behind the net. The Devils two, the Rangers one. Sergei Zuboff. Graves to the blue line, held up from behind and an offside. And on the far side, sticks getting up behind on this draw. Faceoff will be one back deep. First Driver and Glenn Anderson have gone at it before the faceoff, but they separated. 30 seconds left on the power play. Ryan Leach comes back out. Leach sending it in. On the hard around, Anderson let it go. Kicked in by Karpatsev. Back to Karpatsev. He and Leach at the points. Devils challenge the puck. Come right at it. And it works. Driver went after it. Carpenter banged it out. 15 seconds on the Ranger advantage. Bobby Carpenter up on the forecheck. Rangers down 2-1. Their power play has only 7 seconds left on it. Kovalev in. Kovalev along the board still has it. Back to Glenn Anderson. Anderson lost it. Stevens took control. Back to Anderson. Power play's over. Devils have killed it off. And the Rangers are 1-for-4 tonight on the power play. Leach hit by Guerin. Turned it around to Karpatsev. Did the Devils protect that 2-1 lead? This will not be icing. They wave it off. Niedermeyer comes back to get it. Scott Niedermeyer of the Devils. 14:23 to go, third period. Devils 2, Rangers 1. The Devils win, and they'll even the series up to a piece. Glenn Healy kicked it away. Healy came on in the first period. Mike Richter had started. Score was 2-0. Guerin had that second goal. Healy came in and has been in since. In the middle, Gilbert shot blocked. Brodeur was there. Zuboff steps up to hold it in. Behind the net, Gilbert. Gilbert to Nemchinov, taken away by Zalapukin. Larry Zalapukin along the boards, gets it out of the zone. 3-on-3, Zalapukin in with Dowd and Garrett. Puck checked away to center. Played near side, Gilbert, Nemchinov. Rangers running out of legs, and Lowe brings it in offside. There you see the 2-1 score. Devils got both those goals in the first period. Number 1 and 2 teams in the National Hockey League, and a great series underway here in the New Jersey Devils. And you see 4-1, the advantage here in this period on the shots, 2019, as the Rangers have cut into what had been a distinct shot advantage for the Devils. Cleared around, and Trusky could not get it out of the zone. Stevens in the corner with Larmer. Behind the net, Messier tried to tip it in front. Carpenter right there with him. Bobby Carpenter, here's Lemieux. Lemieux's got the break. Leach trying to catch him. Claude Lemieux! Saved by Glenn Healy! Put that one in your memory bank as this game rolls on. Larmer, cross ice. In with it, Matteau. Shot, blocked. Matteau, centered. Couldn't tip it. Tommy Avalon was there as Messier was cutting through the middle. Claude Lemieux, a chance to give the New Jersey Devils that two-goal lead back. Rangers are offside here, so the Devils will get the free out, and they do. Lemieux at center. Lemieux sends it in. Glenn Healy played in only one playoff game prior to tonight. That was against the Washington Capitals. He's been in there now for over a full period and a half. Anderson in the corner, Fetisov with him. Backed it up, Bobby Holick stole it. Fetisov's got it. Up to John McClain, tipped the center. Lowe steps up, Zuboff there with him. Zuboff off the board. Niedermeyer batted it away. Zuboff will give chase. Brian Noonan had to back that one up. Rangers having trouble. McClain and Lowe. Rangers unable to move it out of the zone here. Near side for Zuboff. Zuboff had to leave it again. Richie the check. Kovalev cross ice for Lowe. Richie catches up with him. Finally just flipped out for Graves. Played there by Niedermeyer. Chased down by Kovalev at his own blue line. McClain on him. Tied him up. Kovalev trying to get away. McClain just stayed there with him. Kovalev was hanging on to McClain's stick. Kovalev was asking Marinelli for the call. Tipped in by McClain into the seats.
Well, Jay Wells just went back and tapped Glenn Healy on the pads. And you know what he was saying? Nice save on Claude Lemieux. Terrific save. All the way from in behind the Devil's net. It came out to Tom Chorsky, and he just relayed to Claude Lemieux, who was on the fly. Brian Leach made up a lot of ground here and actually was able to get his stick on Lemieux just as he came in on Glenn Healy. Right there, but I don't think Leach did enough to throw Lemieux off. We'll just call that a terrific save by Glenn Healy.
Keeps that game at just one. Hard hit on the far side, Karpatsev, as he took down Peluso. Healy came out to play that. Karpatsev back. Karpatsev got it away into the middle. Rangers trying to break. Nemchinov, Danico in front. That's a ticketing. But the puck was behind him and bouncing. Randy McKay, his driver, was back there with him. Peluso swept it in. Peluso tips it in deeper. Near side, Bobby Holik. Holik of the Devils. It's a good shot to the face from Jay Wells. McKay! Save by Healy on Randy McKay that time. Two good scoring chances for the New Jersey Devils. Puck ends up in the Ranger bench. 11:19 left to go in the third. Bobby Carpenter again out to take the faceoff. Again, Mark Messier will take the draw against him. Messier continuing his scoring streak as he picked up an assist in this game. He has the third best plus minus of the playoffs. The Rangers have the top four in that plus minus category. Over Brodeur's stick, Troy Koser. Koser to Messier. Messier, Matteau, and Koser on the line. Lukabum plays it back at center. That's a fire up line right there. They can really skate. Stefan Richey back to get it. Richey up for Millen. Didn't touch it. Then Healy comes out of the net to play it. Healy clears it around the boards. Rangers down a goal. Lesa Tikkanen off the near side. Niedermeyer will play this. Shots are 22-19 in favor of the Devils, who have the 2-1 lead. Richey, Lowe takes him down and is going to get a penalty. Kevin Lowe will draw the holding call, and the Devils will get a power play when we come back. Kevin Lowe in the penalty box for holding a very unhappy Ranger. He goes at 9:29. Kevin Lowe has been to the penalty box three times in this game, and the Devils have a power play. They have scored, as you see, 1 for 3 tonight. This is a huge chance to go up by 2. Blocked by Healy on the centering pass by Dowd. Richie and Guerin scored in the first for the Devils. Nateau in the second period for the Rangers. That has been it on the board. Tommy Avila working the power play with Stevens at the point. Stevens dumped it. Shot on Healy. That one wide on him. Big windup for Billy Guerin.
Look where the puck ended up, though. When you shoot wide, if you shoot wide on the long side from that angle, you usually have to pedal all the way back down to behind your net to get it to start again.
Best penalty killing unit in the playoffs belongs to the New York Rangers. During the regular season, they were third best. Ticketum dropped it down into Steve Larmer, and that hits the side of the net. Larmer drops it back. Leach shorthanded, missed that one wide. What a chance the Rangers had right there, shorthanded. Larmer kind of stopped as he was breaking into the net. Here's Steve Larmer again, backs it up for Esa Tikkanen. Larmer had me fooled. I thought he was stopping for something. Then he picked it up again and went in. Lemieux drives it into the corner. Bukaboom with him. John McLean, puck underneath. He and Bukaboom came free. Centering pass, Esa Tikkanen's there.
Oh, man, did Jeff Bukaboom ever show us his strength on that shove of John McLean.
Scott Niedermeyer and Esa Tikkanen. Tikkanen just left it there. Niedermeyer picks it up. 20 seconds left to go on the power play for the Devils. Driver over to McLean. McLean lost it to Wells, played by Bukaboom. Bukaboom around and out of the zone. Anderson. Short-handed Rangers. Anderson in. Poke checked away to center by Driver. Cleared up by McLean. Chorsky taken away by Nemchinov. Power play is over. And the Devils do not convert. The Rangers had a couple of chances as it's batted into the seats.
Well, that must be Jeff Bukaboom's helmet that Kevin Lowe has just retrieved. He got sandwiched and headlocked and everything. But when he got up out of the headlock, what a force he was. There's his helmet. It just went flying off. And John McLean is standing over him. When Bukaboom got up, he just ripped McLean into the net. Caught him right under the chin and just threw him down. Oh, ha, ha, ha. John McLean tried to throw that baby into the stands. You know that?
Didn't make it.
Wondered where he was going with it.
Played by Mike Peluso. Peluso, Zubov, McKay, Peluso, and Bobby Holik are out there. Picked up by Kevin Lowe. 8:14 to go, third period. Devils have the 2-1 lead. Steve Larmer over to Stefan Matteau. Matteau couldn't control it. Cleared out by Stevens and cleared up by Peluso. Glenn Healy trying to help out here on the offensive side of it. Lowe tipped it away. Right back, Tommy Avalon into the zone. Wave off any icing. Zubov got it around. Richie stepped up, knocked away by Kovalev. And that's cleared into the seats by John McLean. 7:45 left in the third.
McLean is still revved up after that play behind the net. He missed throwing Bukaboom's helmet into the stands. That tells you how mad he was. He just finished a conference with both linesmen. That was after he skated by Dan Marinelli, the referee, and gave him a piece of his mind.
Bukaboom takes it in behind the net. This game's still very much up for grabs in a very important game here in this series. Game 3 is when a series has been evened up. Vitally important. And the game 4 gives somebody a chance to move on top by 2. And the Rangers have that chance, but the Devils even it up with a victory here. Graves sends it in. The Messier up ice that time, hanging at the blue line. Kosar moved over. Chorsky cleared it out of the zone. Leach. Messier. Messier and Lemieux battling. Leach has got to chase it down deep in his own end. Devils make the line change. They come over the boards. Adam Graves with it. Billy Guerin came right after. Knocked down by Stevens. Back for Guerin. Guerin and Graves collide again. Wells pushes it by Dowd. Tommy Avalon back to Dowd and in. Devils dumping it deep every chance they get. Zalapukin scores! Zalapukin! Devils 3, Rangers 1!
heads-up play by Valeri Zelepukin. Glenn Healy appeared to get caught back there. He stopped to try to take Zelepukin with his stick, and then look at Healy. It looked like he almost wanted to follow him around. Instead of getting back to the front, it looked like Healy was trying to follow Zelepukin around to poke check him. Never came close. An easy wraparound goal has given the Devils a 3-1 lead.
26 goals during the regular season for Valeri Zelepukin. His fourth of the playoffs this year. And a huge goal. A 3-1 lead for the Devils with 6:30 to go in the third. Now the Rangers going to pour it on and take chances. Kevin Lowe held it in. Dropped back. Zuboff. Zuboff, the defenseman, center shot. Brodeur the save and hangs on to the rebound. Kevin Lowe, Brodeur the save. The Devils a 3-1 lead. Zelepukin second against the Rangers. Fourth of this year's playoffs, unassisted at 13-18. That one blocked and ends up in the seats. Kevin Lowe just took a shot at Lemieux, who ends up on his wallet. Faceoff will be outside the Ranger blue line. The Rangers came out in this game not as prepared to go at it as the Devils were. The Devils got that early first period lead 2-0. The Rangers responded midway through the game, picking the physical play up. They're able to convert one, but the Devils have not let up. All the Rangers were able to do was get it on an even plane. Well, that has not been enough thus far in this game with 5:48 left to go. On the boards, we get a whistle for the faceoff. Rangers questioning the faceoff situation here again. They wanted it deeper in the zone. A tougher draw here for Larmer. He gets it done, though, to Zuboff. Zuboff moving in the shot off the blocker of Brodeur. Martin Brodeur. This has been about the easiest game he's had, and it hasn't been easy. It's far better than the previous ones where he faced a barrage of shots off the Rangers. Bobby Holik had that one blocked. Glenn Healy over to get it. Healy off the boards. McKay. Randy McKay in the corner, tied up by Gilbert. Holik has it. Zuboff doing battle with him. Holik's got it in the skates. Randy McKay in to help out. This is running precious time off. Devils don't mind this. That's why this line's out there. They're just mucking it up in the corners. Greg Gilbert. He gets the hit from Bobby Holik. Puck came to Lowe. Kevin Lowe brings it out. Lowe moves it off right side. Brodeur's got it in the midsection and hangs on. There's the Ranger. We'll try and pump it on. Larmer from outside the circle that time.
Well, now Mike Keenan comes with his power unit. Messier has come over the boards. Graves and Anderson, they have not been together since the early part of the first period. Leach and Bukaboom back on defense. Enough juggling. Got to get the strong guys out there now. But have you noticed over the last 10 or 12 minutes how the Devils have kept everybody on the outside? The Rangers haven't been able to get in at all. And this line of Bobby Holik and Peluso and Randy McKay have done a great job when they have played of making sure the Rangers stay at their end.
Can muck it up with that rock line. Stevens plays it up to the point. Both of them trying to send it in blocked, and then he had a cut down. Tom Chorsky was ready to break it up ice. Near side for Graves. Martin Brodeur to Stevens. Stevens in the middle for Bobby Carpenter. Carpenter off to Lemieux. Lemieux sends it in, got whacked by Leach as he did so. Bukaboom back to get it. Chorsky's there with him. Reversing direction to Leach with Messier. Ryan Leach starting it up. Leach, Messier, their ice time in this game severely reduced from what they've had in the previous playoff games. Bukaboom sends it in over Tommy Avalon's stick. Stevens there for the Devils. Adam Graves stripped him of the puck. Stevens comes right back to get it. Comes up to Chorsky. Chorsky, Karpontsev and Leach are both back. Chorsky with McLean, sent it into the corner, over to get it Dowd, his shot save made by Glenn Healy, Karpontsev there, Dowd moved in on him, 4 minutes left in the third, the Devils 3 and the Rangers 1, New Jersey Devils here at home, 4 wins, 4 losses in the playoffs, Rangers on the road, 4-1.
But we've seen now how the Devils can play with a lead late in a game. They've got one man in the forecheck. He hardly puts any pressure on. They fall back in the neutral zone and squeeze people off or force them to dump it in the way Nemchinov just had to.
And are very successful at that. They used it all year long. Baird out of the zone. Corey Millen giving chase. Jay Wells back there. Wells gets there first. Millen puts the hit on him. Karpontsev picks up the puck. Esa Tikkanen trying to move through the middle. Tied up by Billy Guerin, who's had a very strong game. Guerin's got to be one of the 3 stars in this one. Karpontsev behind the net. Rangers down by 2. Closer on the far side, intended for Esatikin, and pass was behind him. Ken Danica. And we are down another minute, ticking off the clock here. 3 minutes left to go in this third period. Guerin back for Driver. Driver driven deep by Stefan Matteau as the only Ranger goal. Driver having trouble. Got help from Stevens. Lowe able to hold it in for the Rangers. Rangers just want to get one here to cut it to one so they can get that goaltender pulled a little later in the game. Working from behind the net. Point. Kevin Lowe's shot didn't get any of that. Stevens up for Bobby Holik. Holik with Lowe on him, away to Guerin, and Guerin the flip. 2:30 left to go in the third. Devils up by two. The pass dropped, almost intercepted by Randy McKay, who gets it back. McKay moving in. Can't get by. Sergei Zubov took him down. No call. McKay got away with a hook. Marowelli's going to let him go. Brought up by Anderson. Glenn Anderson moving in. Poke checked away by Stevens. Tom Trusky's blue liner saved by Healy. Leach back to get it off the boards. Graves. Messier. Anderson wide right. Can't get it to him. Stevens clears it back out. Richey, Guerin, and Zelopukhin have scored, and the Rangers are offside. Matteau, the only goal for the Devils. Goals have come so hard at such a cost in this series. That's a freebie. And you earn it because you earned it a long time ago, a few games ago.
Boy, coming into this game, the Devils had only scored 2 goals in the last 7 periods of the series. So this is a big night for them getting 3.
Against the New York Rangers. They've given up just 1.75 in goals against in the playoffs. Centering pass intended for Joey Kosar, knocked away to Zelopukhin. There's Zelopukhin. Will feather that in behind the net. Healy goes back to get it. Minute 34 left to go. Devils 3 and the Rangers 1. Near side to Leach. Martin Brodeur let that one go into the corner after reaching for it. Kosar got there. Kosar and Driver. Driver pokes it away. Leach. Moving in on Carpenter. Leach tried to center. Good play by Driver. Tom Chorsky, he's got Lemieux. Broken up. Centering pass, Zubov was there to get it. Cleared it again by Nemchinov. And we are down to the final minute of game 4. And the New Jersey Devils, leading by 2, are looking to even the series at 2 games apiece. Gilbert sends it in off the boards. Larmer. Stevens is there. Back for Larmer. Larmer's shot over the head of Brodeur. Lemieux. Healy still in net at the other end. Lowe has to drop it back for Zubov. You're looking at the time remaining in the third. Lowe. Matteau blocked by Bobby Holik. Holik tended for Richey. Devils send it in. Lowe is there. Rangers know this series is tied. 24 seconds left. Not only will there be a game Monday night at Madison Square Garden, there'll be another game here next Wednesday night. All of them will be coming your way on our National Hockey Night ESPN Stanley Cup coverage. The New Jersey Devils, an impressive 3-1 win against the Rangers, and this series is tied at 2 games apiece.